Bueno, más o menos, 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 más cartridges of the true ribs aponeurosis of the external oblique muscle. This origin. Next. Insertion. Lateral lip of the intertubicular sulcus of the humerus. At the humerus. Action. Flexes and adducts arm, rotators arm medially. That's all. By position. Show name and show name 2, 3, 4, 5. That's all. Next, under the pectoral major muscle, situated pectoral minor muscle. Pectoral minor muscle. Outer surface of upper margin of the 3/5 ribs and attached to the coracoid process. Action. Lowers lateral angle of scapula and protracts scapula. That's all about this muscle. Next muscle, subclavian muscle. Start from the cartilage of the first rib, attach to the clavicle, middle part, and action move of the clavicle. If you want to read about this muscle, you must find this picture, page 3. Subclavius muscle, upper border of the first rib and its cartilages, inferior surface of the middle third of the clavicle and anchors and depressus scleracal. Next, anterior serratus muscle, this one. Find anterior serratus muscle, serratus anterior muscle. The lateral surface of the upper 8-9 ribs, this one. 9 ribs. Costal surface of the middle border of the scapula. Protracts scapula and holds it against thoracic wall. Actually, that's all about this muscle. Next, external intercostal muscles. External intercostal muscles start from the lower body of the ribs. Lower body. This one. Origin. Upper body of the ribs, below ribs of origin, this one. Action. Elevators supports intercostal spaces in inspiration and expiration. Elevators ribs in inspiration. Next, internal intercostal ribs. Internal lower body of the ribs. Upper body of the ribs below rib of origin. Elevators ribs. These are superficial muscles of the thoracic cave. Next, transversus torsus muscle. Transversus torsus muscle. Internal surface of the costal cartilage, 2-6 ribs. And attach intercostal posterior surface of the lower ribs. Of the lower sternum and depresses ribs and costal cartilages. Excellent. That's all about this muscle. And when you will prepare homework, you must study so. Show muscle, name, origin, and such like. That's all. Next, diaphragm. Phrenic muscle. Diaphragm is the part of the muscular system, situated between the thoracic cage and abdominal cavity. This one, diaphragm. Diaphragm contains, if you look from abdominal cavity, this view from the thoracic cage, this view from the abdominal cavity. This one, sternal part of the diaphragm. This one, costal part of the diaphragm. And this part is the lumbar part of the diaphragm. Lumbar part of the diaphragm. Central part of the diaphragm, name central tendon of the diaphragm. Diaphragm, origin, xiphoid process, lower six costal cartilages, L1, L3, vertebra. Insertion, convert into the central tendon. Action, draws central tendon down and toward during inspiration. That's all. At the diaphragm, we can see into the central tendon, around of the inferior vena cava, this one. Lumbar part of the diaphragm contains the right crass of the diaphragm, right inferior phrenic or right crass of the diaphragm, and this one, left crass of the diaphragm, left crass of the diaphragm. This one. Between the crass, we can see the hiatus esophagus. Through this opening, pass the esophagus. And this one, hiatus aorticus, between the crass. Through this hiatus, pass the abdominal aorta. Abdominal. This one, diaphragm. Next, abdominal muscle. This one, abdomen. Abdomen is the space between the xiphoid process, costal arc, and line between the anterior superior iliac spine and pubic tubercle. This one, region is abdomen. And the abdomen, we differ anterior group of the muscles of the abdomen. This one, it contains the rectus abdominal muscle and pyramidal muscle, pyramidalis muscle. This rectus abdominis muscle. And lateral group contain external oblique muscle, internal oblique muscle, and transversal muscle. External oblique muscle, internal and transversal abdominal muscle. The rectus muscle, it has segmental structure, contain 4, 5, or 6 segments. Between the segments, we can see tendons intersections. Start rectus muscle. Rectus abdominis muscle, pubic symphysis, pubic crest, start. Xiphoid process, costal cartilages, 5, 7. Flexed trunk, compresses abdominal viscera, action. External, internal, and transversal muscle. External oblique muscle, start from the external surfaces of the ribs, 5th till 12. Insertion. Linea alba. Pubic tubercle. Anterior half of the iliac crest. Actions. Flexed action there. Compresses and supports abdominal viscera. Flexes and rotated tongue. Internal oblique muscle. Origin. Thoracolumbar fossa. Anterior two-thirds of the iliac crest. Anterior half of inguinal ligament. This one. Start of this muscle. Insertion. Inferior border of the ribs. 10-12. Linea alba. Pubis. Via conjunct tendon. This one. Transversal abdominis muscle. Internal surface of the costal cartilage, 7-12 ribs, thoracolumbar fossa, iliac crest, little third of the inguinal ligament. This one, start. And insertion linear alba with the conivals of the internal oblique crest and pectoral pubic via conjoint tendon. Action compresses and supports abdominal viscera. That's all. These are characteristic of muscle. And when you will study at home muscles, at first you are fine muscle. Remember name muscles. Open this table and determine origin, insertion, and action. If you study origin, you must find these points where origin this muscle. Where we study insertion muscle, find where is insertion this muscle, and action. Function of this muscle. This principle of the study of the muscles. You must know name, show, origin, insertion, action. That's all at this period. Later we'll tell about vascularization and innervation. But in September. Doctors, the little group of the muscles of the abdomen divided on the muscular part and aponeurotic part. This one muscular part of this muscle, and this one aponeurotic part of this muscle. Aponeurotic part has specific relation with the rectus abdominis muscle, and these aponeurotics form the sheath of the rectus abdominis muscle. This space, this one, named sheath of the rectus abdominis muscle. Position of the aponeurotic parts of the abdominal muscle, little group. For the external abdominal muscle, the aponeurosis of this muscle cover rectus abdominis muscle from anterior side. Internal oblique muscle is aponeurosis at the region of the rectus divided on the anterior layer and posterior layer. And both are attached between themselves at the linea alba. And transversus abdominis muscle is aponeurosis, they behind the rectus abdominis muscle and connect with the opposite side at the linea alba. This situation we see above this line. This line named arcuate line. At this space we see this view. Below arcuate line we see that all aponeurotic parts of the little abdominal muscles lay before the rectus abdominis muscle. And sheath of the rectus abdominis from the backside formed by the transversalis fossa and peritoneum. This space. Next. Very important structure, inguinal canal. Inguinal canal. What is it in your canal? Give me your copybook. Copy.
Yes.
What is it in your canal? in Lucena form by the upper neurotic departments of the external oblique muscles. If you make this section perpendicular of this ligament and look from the internal side, we see this one. External oblique abdominal muscle. It gives upper neurotic part, this one. This part starts from the anterior superior iliac spine. This is muscular part of the external. This upper neurotic part starts from this line and attach to the pubic tubercle. And from this ligament, give bend to inside. This part named aponeurosis of the external oblique abdominal muscle. And at this point, this aponeurosis named in the ligament. Internal oblique muscle attached here. This one, external oblique muscle. This one, internal oblique muscle. Next, here, this one, internal, attached to this ligament, this one. Next, transversal, attached here. Transversus abdominis muscle. Transversus abdominis muscle. And backside covered by the transversal fascia and peritoneum. And this space named inguinal canal. This space. Inguinal canal contains at the male the seminal funiculus, spermatic cord. At the female, at the inguinal canal, situated the teres ligament uteri. Yes, the length I talked about it. The length of the inguinal ligament 5 centimeters. This is view of the deep inguinal ring. Here, exit of the inguinal canal, and here entrance to the inguinal canal, superficial ring of the inguinal canal. This one, male inguinal canal. Here, superficial ring. Here, deep ring. Male spermatic cord situated in the inguinal canal. This one. And the male here situated only teres ligament uteri. This is view of the inguinal canal. This space from the deep inguinal ligament superficial ring is the inguinal canal. This one inner ligament, inguinal canal situated here. From the inguinal go out to the deferens duct. Deferens duct. And this one. This deep ring of the, and this superficial ring of the inguinal canal. The space under the inguinal ligament divided lacuna musculorum, this part, and lacuna vasorum, this part, under the inguinal ligament. Through the lacuna vasorum pass the femoral artery, femoral vein. Through the lacuna musculorum pass the iliopsoas muscle. This is inguinal canal. Here, female inguinal canal. Female inguinal canal. Uterus. Uh, the femur. Femur in the ligament. This is the ligament. And here, male and female difference. I talk about difference. Female cannot spermatic cord situated on the pelvic ligament of the uterus, and male three spermatic cords. And the female one artery, and the male three arteries. Testicular, cremasteric, and ductus reflex artery. That's all, doctors. So this is your whole book to the next class. Table, please. Muscles of the test. 297. Diaphragm. Fascia. Muscles of the abdomen. She's in the canal. Till muscle of the neck. 12. Doctors, you have 20 minutes, please. Start to look.